次のゲーム、ベアナックル2ですが、何度も言いますが、解説の方いらっしゃいません。もし、プレイしたことがあるという方さえ、少しでも知っているという方がいれば、下の、チャンネル下部のディスコードのマークからディスコードに参加していただければ、案内いたしますので、この音声として解説の音声として入っていただけると幸いです。また、もちろんコメントでの参加も大歓迎です。私のベアナックル2の知識は、音楽が、星野雄三さんってことぐらいですかね、本当に。
もう始まりますかね。That puts us just a little bit closer to that $1 million mark. So please, everyone, let's make that happen.
バイブルスタンプはそのまあ今コメントで出てる泣いてるような人の顔の絵文字なんですけれども、絵文字、まあ、エモートなんですけれども、まあ、これ、コメントでもありますが、The Binding of Isaac というゲームの主人公のキャラクターの顔ですね。さあ、始まりました。スケジュールは少し遅れてますかね、当初よりは。
Then I start. Oops, I totally messed it up, but it's okay.
It's all good. That gives us time for a roll call. I am Mike Uyama.
I'm Dagrin.
I'm Murphy. まあ、でも今日に入ってから特別遅れたというわけではないです。
And now it's on Mania.
Yeah. 確か、今日の午前4時ぐらいにあった、マリオストーリーか何かの時に、機材トラブルか何かで30分ほど遅れていたはずですね。これぞ清く正しい、清く正しいというのなんですが、ベルトスクロールアクションという感じがしますね。
Like a super joy, and like that you'd use in other beat 'em ups, which has a lot of invincibility. And because you're Max, it also does a ton of damage. The reason why he's using Max is because Max is the best character in the game. There is a bit of debate between Max and Axel, but it's generally agreed among like the highest level Streets of Rage 2 players is that once you get a good grip in the game, Max is the best just because he outputs so much damage and he has lots of good setups on the enemies and the bosses.He's also, ironically, the second most mobile character in the game because of his slide and the thunder tackle.
Yeah, he's very mobile, moving left and right, but if you have to move on the depth axis, he does end up being quite slow, yeah. Since the only way to move on the depth axis in this game is his default movement.
And the thing about this game is that it's very, very random, so you can never really play the same way twice.You can account for spawns and the like, and there are certain pixels that he'll want to be on so that he only spawns a certain amount of enemies. But for this stage, it doesn't really matter that much because it's just a lot of like filler, you know, low level enemies that aren't too hard to kill.
この攻撃時の音がかなり気持ちいい感じしますね。
Fall down to the ground, actually take any damage. There's a particular trick that you can do where you can actually just safely land on the ground even after being thrown.
Yeah, you just hold up and jump, and you're good.
Yeah, that's a common mechanic in all three of the Streets of Rage games. It's don't know why they decided to do it, but it's a cool, unique thing about the series.
So signals are less like deadly, and they're more annoying because the throws cost you time, but they're not really gonna hurt you.
So we're coming up to Jack here.
一応ゲームとしてはまあ。ゴールデンアックス、先ほどあったゴールデンアックスのシステムを土台にしつつ、ヒットしていたファイナルファイトのエッセンスを加えた、レアナックル1の 正当進化がベアナック2のようですね。
It's not the best damage, but it's the best DPS because it outputs the damage really fast and it counts as a hit, so it can hit multiple enemies for the same damage as you hit.
前作ベアナック1の時はゴールデンアックスと同じような必殺ボムのようなものがあったんですが、今回からは体力消費の無敵、そして周囲を吹っ飛ばすメガクラッシュに変更されたほか、スペシャル攻撃も追加された
ですね。
あとは今までの攻撃はダンプ中の攻撃は全て相手をダウンしていましたが、今回からはダウンさせないような攻撃もあるので、ジャンプからのコンボ攻撃といったものもできる。
A specific pre-programmed reaction to certain actions you take. So anytime you jump near a Donovan, they're probably going to try and uppercut you. And a lot of times you can beat that attack in various ways with a jump, but if your timing's off, it does mean you usually get hit by
it. 他には背面攻撃、ため攻撃、ダッシュ攻撃、つかみ攻撃、裏回り、後つかみ攻撃、ジャンプ投げ、ニュートラル投げと、かなり攻撃の種類が豊富ですね。見ていても実際結構いろいろな攻撃が出ているように思いますね。
Hit the enemies and take a little bit of damage than the enemies hitting you, which will probably be more damaging to yourself than just using the special, and you're not getting any damage on the enemies.
Max's special also just generally does pretty good damage.
Oh yeah, it's really powerful. Like the game has a rating system, and you know Max has power, but his special is only 2, but it's really like.I would give it, you know, the 3 stars because he's.
なるほど、多分後ろつかみ攻撃は多分ダメージが高いんでしょう。
あと、
ま
あ、画面見ていると気づくとは思うんですが、左下に自分の体力が、その下に現在攻撃している敵の体力が出ますね。
Start a loop like that. If he mistimes it, he'll do an overhead swing, which you really don't want to see as Max because it's very slow, and that's why he's always sliding or tackling to end his combos.
Yeah, every once in a while you'll see him turn around and do the back kick as the ender too, which is another good move for it.
Yeah, and what you're noticing is that he's always tackling into Barbin.Because what he's trying to do is
あとは今作、登場キャラクター、登場キャラクターというか、操作キャラクターが4体いるんですが、今回はマックスという、まあ、主人公はアクセルなんですけども、アクセルの親友のプロレスラー、親友のために試合をポカスという、友達思いの性格のようですね。まあ、という、まあ、4体のキャラクターいるんですけれども、4体のキャラクターの声は、なんと、作曲者である、星野雄三氏が、自らの声をピッチを調整して再現して、まあ、声を当てているということで、実質 CV 腰を入れたということですね。
Going and just aggroing all these enemies is like the polar opposite of how most people play Mania. Like most people, when you're trying to play Mania, in order to contain all of the stuff that's just happening, you really have to like wait and get like a couple guys at most on screen.
Yeah.And he does that a couple of times for the bosses, but like overall, he just plays very aggressively and handles it very well.
Yeah, and there you can see Donovan started trying to uppercut him, but he got hit before the uppercut hit, so that's how you can kind of use theirs.
So what he did there is that if you're deep enough inside an enemy sprite, you can hit them, then turn around, and you'll get a back turn throw on them, which sets up backbreakers or suplexes.So, bikers, they're not too dangerous now, but later in the game, they're one of the most low-key dangerous enemies in the game. They don't do a lot of damage, but they have a very fast punch that knocks you down.
They can also put you in a full Nelson, and that is a good way to get set into a lot of damage.
ストーリーの方は、一応、
so, like,
リアナックル1の頃は、アクセル、ブレイズ、アダムという3人が、まあ、元警官なんですけど、3人は。元警官が街の平和を取り戻すために戦うといったような感じなんですが、2の時は、その、前作の操作キャラクターの1人であるアダムが、何者かによってさらわれてしまい、それをアダムを助けるために立ち上がった4人、前作の登場キャラクターである、アクセルとブレイズに加え、 キャラクターのジョエス・マックス、そしてアダムの弟のサミーという少年が追加されたということですね。
So it's not like the best DPS. And he got hit in purpose there, so he could set up that grab. And what he did was the headlock, which is actually the most damaging move in the game, but it's not used too often for two reasons. If there's multiple enemies, they can hit you out of it. You have no invulnerability during the headlock, unlike most grab moves. And that
damaging move, it takes a while. ベルトアクション、ベルトスクロールアクションがずっと続いてますけど、敵、肩パッドをつけている正規末系の敵キャラクター多いですね。
Considering you gain a fractional amount of health on every screen transition anyway, it's just kind of a free little time saver.
You might be going, oh, a one up for safety, what is this? Well, Mania is very, very difficult, and you know.The later stages can really blow through a lot of lives.
Yeah, this is the calm part of the game.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
This is just easy street right now. Yeah. It's no big deal.
Do we have time for a quick donation?
Sure. Sure.
Cool. We have a $500 donation from Chad Surratt, who says, you've got this, Antho Pants. Remember to get on their level and hit the guy.
Yep, hit the guy. Thanks, Chad.
Yeah, we're going to be coming up on the boss here, so...
He's going to want to kind of... It's hard to tell because of the way the background shifts, but basically he's going to want to basically get to a certain line and then go back immediately, so he only spawns one jet. And he got it.
And, well, it spawned Donovan's in this fight, the multiple jet things later. All right, so here he's manipulating to do this punch attack so he can backbreaker him, which...
コシロ映像師の妹であるコシロ綾乃さんが参加しているという情報ありがとうございます。ジェンナックルっていうのはメインデザイナーなんですね。
Getting grabs on jet is such a cool strat.
It's a very problematic enemy.
Yeah, and it's not as easy as it looks.
本当に兄弟で兄は音楽担当妹はグラフィック担当ってことになりますね。
Now our Streets of Rage fight takes us to the amusement park, I guess. The locations in this game are pretty wild.
And so is the music, but that's why it's one of the best soundtracks on the Genesis, if not the best.
Yeah, it's...
星野彩乃さんは、いや、星野雄三さんが、日本ファルコム退社した後に立ち上げられた会社に一緒に入っていたはずだと思います。そうですね、つまり、妹さんがこのカサパッドレンチをデザインしたはずですね。予定時間。一応余裕を持って書いているので、57分よりは短く終わるとは思いますが、まあ、大体57分あると思っていただいて結構だと思います。
Yeah, so signals have a very specific AI quirk where they won't really attack you if your back is facing them.
Yeah, they'll only throw you.
Yeah, so...Getting that whole group, they'll try and approach and throw, but then you do a back jump and kick all four of them into the corner.
That was a very good screen.
Yeah.
Another thing you might notice is anytime that, that he does the knee drop, a lot of times they'll try and like, do something random and just.
難易度が、ベアナックル2には、ベリーイージーから、イージー、ノーマル、ハード、ハーデストと続いて、マニアという一番難しいモードがあるんですが、その、一番難しいマニア、なんですよね。この奏者の方の記録、ワールドレコードなんですが、51分39秒という記録があるので、まあ、さすがに、この大会場一発勝負で51分39秒を切るのは難しいでしょうが、まあ、51分39秒よりは長く、57分よりは短いぐらいで終わると思っていただければ。
So here's where we're going to be introduced to one of the most annoying enemies in the game, the ninja.
Yeah. However, Like most of the enemies in this game, there is an AI quirk to the ninja. If you are far enough away and the ninja is not holding a weapon, he will it will jump towards you at a fixed distance. And if you have good positioning, Max can just jump in and you can set up a backbreaker with them.
Yeah, which is especially interesting because normally the ninjas, if you jump at them, teleport away from you. So kind of a cute little quirk.
And Anthopants is kind of crazy and fighting both ninjas.
そうですね。あと、コメントで何度か言われていますが、
2
人プレイまでできるので、2人プレイも楽しいのではないかと。ベルトスクロールアクションは2人プレイが楽しいというイメージがありますね、私は。片パッドもそうですが、ベルトスクロールアクション、忍者が多いけどですね。
Doing all these crazy strats when I first saw him practicing and I first met him. And he's like, I won't do, you know, this stuff during the marathon. Of course, one was fighting both of those ninjas at once.
ただ、ゴールデンアックスのファンタジー世界には、カタパッド出てきても、忍者は出てこなかったので、やはりカタパッドの方が上ですか。
Enemies in particular, I find really interesting because just these two Electras tend to kind of.
ここは多分、ステージ、遊園地でしょうが、右のアトラクションのオブジェクト、すごいですね、これは。
Fortunately, the knife isn't too much damage. So, it's the most dangerous part is just getting zoned out a lot and chipped away rather than like one big hit.
Yeah.
And what's nice about the refights on most mid-bosses is that they lose their invulnerability periods as they get up, so he can set up backbreakers and the like really easily.
Yeah, and that's true, like even sub-bosses, like Bino was in stage one, and the sub-boss version of him, he had to stall a bit, whereas this one he can just kind of do whatever. So, we're here, this alien lair,
Because Aliens was a popular movie at the time, an HR Geiger, why not?
コメントありますが、このベアナックル2、そして先ほどプレイしていた、一つ前のゴールデンアックス、ともに、現在 Steam で98円で購入できます。なんとたったの98円。
Swing animations, but the katana does way more damage
than that. That's a good loop.
That's a good move.
Well played.
So, one kind of quirk there, when Max grabs an enemy, he has to drop whatever weapons he's holding. And the way weapons work in this game is you get to drop them three times, I think. And then if you drop them a fourth time, it'll vanish. So he has to make sure he doesn't lose track of his sword too many times or else he won't have it. Which, for this section, isn't a death trap or anything, but it is, he still wants it.
Also, there's a hidden one up coming up here.
しかもおまくに、本当ですか？これおまくになんですか？
Yeah, you basically have to hit the middle of his face.
Yeah, and he just kind of drives around, and if he runs into you, he does damage.
And the reason why he's using the back of the sword is because it hits higher, and also hits faster, because that's
because that's how you swing a sword, is you just reach way behind your head and stick it out
there. In one frame, yeah. You play just special it.
このボスどういう敵なのかよくわからないですね。
That was a pretty good fight, all things considered. It's a very random fight.
Yeah. Getting that ninja is pretty key.
So here you're seeing the jump manipulation that Mike was talking about earlier. And,
wants to kill these ninjas here before the boss.
Yeah, and you might be like, oh, why don't you spawn the boss with the ninjas? Well, that would really just slow things down in general, just because you'd have to fight three enemies at once, and it's a lot easier to handle if you only have...this one guy to deal with and just manipulate him like that. So if you just jump and he's close to you like that, if you're at a certain positioning, which the backbreaker and the suplex sets up perfectly, he'll just constantly jump at you, it'll whiff, and you just get back throws and he dies.
Yeah.
Quality attack there.
Yeah. Yeah. A lot of the, a lot of the jumping anti-air moves that enemies have really deceptively bad hitboxes against the player when you're jumping. Don't know why. That's why I didn't hit you.
Wow. Sure, why not?
Excuse me?
And that's why he wanted to take care of the ninjas beforehand, because if he didn't, then he wouldn't have been able to set that up, and he would have just had a net loss in time.
Okay, well, it's important to remember to do baseball.
Yeah, exactly. No, you mean do baseball.
Do baseball. So yeah, pretty good swarm of mostly the same enemies we've been seeing for a while.
We're gonna start
seeing a lot more variety here in this stage. They kind of realize that we've seen these guys. The game starts
The game starts to ramp up a little in stage four, but it's not really until I would say stages 5, 6, and 7 where the game and 8 where the game ramps up.
Yeah,
it's definitely the second half of the game that's the harder half. But I think now would actually be a pretty good time for some donations.
実際かなりさっきから後ろに回ってのつかみ攻撃がうまいですね。
Has reached 9 lives here, so we started with 1 and we've been having a pretty steady net gain.
Yeah,
this is going really well.
And with that, we'll transition into the first one I have to read here. $25 from Deidius. Good, hey GDQ, donating during my favorite beat 'em up of all time, Streets of Rage 2. Excited to see it beaten in Mania at a GDQ, which is something I couldn't do as a child with 9 lives. Donation goes to Runner's Choice.
Most adults can't do it with 9 lives, so I wouldn't feel bad about that.
We also have $10 from Gordo Diamond, who says, go Antho Pants, you're the best. Don't forget to grab the guy.
Oh, grab the guys.
Nice. So if there's a lot of enemies, that's when he elects to do the Thunder Tackle, because that's definitely worth the life sacrifice for the raw damage that you get and positioning.
It also depends just a little bit on where there's health coming up, because there are quite a few health drops in this baseball field.
You can read off some donations now. There's not a lot to talk about in this baseball field.
All right, we also have $10 from Bungie to the Tree. Hello from the front row, Anthopants. Good luck on this amazing run. We also have $50 from the Gecko, who says, a Streets of Rage 2 run? Crank up the volume.
I agree. Shouts to Yuzo Koshiro.
Yeah, great soundtrack.
And $50 from Nick Manesh, who says, so great to see someone using their bare knuckles to take on Streets of Rage 2. Keep up the good work.
Yeah, bare knuckles, the Japanese name of the game.
よろしくお願いします。
So coming up are the fat guys.
Bongo.
And what he's going to try to do is he's going to try to group them together and then try to get the same punch loop he had on the Electra in the bar, because they have a very slow attack animation.
Not quite as slow as Electra though, so it is a more difficult loop than was there.
でももう一度説明しておくと、あの体力消費を行う代わりに、その間は無敵になり、周囲を吹っ飛ばすメガクラッシュ攻撃を割と有効に使っているっていうことですね。
Streets of Rage 1, where he was a boss, and not so much in the other game where that happens.
Yeah, yeah. So for those of you who don't know, in Streets of Rage 1 and 2, if you try to...
1 and 3.
Yeah, sorry, 1 and 3. If you try to grab a fat guy and throw them, then you will just struggle and take damage.
Well, it depends a little bit on the throw, because like strike throws work. But,
oh, yeah, that's true.
But like, if you try and throw them over...
この仕掛けすごいですね。野球のベースのあたりがエレベーターになっている。
The first of the elevators we're going to deal with.
And this is a pretty tough elevator, and this is where the game starts to pick up a little. And so he has to watch out for the Yamato jump kicks, but he just went behind him and set up a nice little loop right there.
Yeah, fortunately you got two walls to work with, which is pretty rare.
多分この雑魚的、どうやってもこの高さ落ちてきてるとやばいと思うんですけど、相当すごいですね。落下ダメージがあるゲームだと死んでいました。
And if he just wants to lock them down, it's just better for him to use a combo instead of a backbreaker, because that'll guarantee that all the enemies stay there. You see that Donovan just slipped out of that backbreaker.
He was intentionally delaying there.
Yeah. That's a pretty common tactic, just to set up better backbreaker damage for groups.
そうですね。少しちょっと今本当に変えないのかと思って今実際に買ってみたんですけど、変えたので変えますね。私は買いました。皆さんも買いましょう。
He still has 9 lives though, so he's good. Yeah, so the game, you can get more than 9 lives, but it doesn't display past 9 lives.
Yeah, I think if he score caps and gets all the secrets, he ends up with 16 total over the course of the game. Just jump out there. It's fine.
And generally in Mania, you do cap the score if you earn one credit and you beat the game.
Yep. So now we're going to fight Abidede, and I'm curious which strategy he's going to use, because there's like 10 different strats for this guy that are all cool. Oh. Yeah, Max is a little bit better at wrestling than Abidede.
Yeah. So the problem is that if you get an enemy off screen like this, you can't follow up with grabs. So he's trying to get him centered on the screen. And
Street of Rage, do you think?
He's not cooperating. Thing is, while this guy's AI is fairly predictable,
God,
he does
fast.
A ton of damage.
Yeah, and if you don't set up your grabs on him, then he wins the priority. So,
woo,
very nice work.
Perfect. That was a perfect fight.
Nothing bad happened at all.
The perfectest fight.
Yeah.
So anyway, now that we've escaped the underground base
world, we're on a boat. That's a very narrow
transition. 私の記憶が確かならば、プロレスラーのアルティメットウォリアーですよね。アルティメットウォリアー、リスペクトな感じのメイクな気がしますね。
ボンゴーズ in particular just...They really went overboard with their health on Mania. They take a lot.
And shouts to Fist of the North Star.
Yeah,
the name Heart.
Heart.
Yeah, there's a theme with all the enemies in the game.
Ah, 日本語勉強しているという方、頑張ってください。
All have bird names like Raven, Condor, and the bikers have like weather effects like hail, storm, gale.
Yeah, it's also really interesting because like the enemy names are actually changed on Mania, so you see a lot of names that you wouldn't normally see. Like we were calling them Donovans, but they're named, I think the typical ones are named like Z on Mania.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah, there's Gooden.
There's Gooden.
Gooden got his neck broken. Yeah, so we're going to see the kickboxers right here.
Yeah.
The kickboxers are the first normal enemy who can block, but they can't block if like you're doing something right as they're standing up. So in this case, when they're spawning one at a time like this, you can kind of...
Yeah. And this is one of the few moments where he really only wants to bait out one at a time. And he took the hit on purpose so he could set up a grab on the kickboxer.
And この辺結構敵のタイプ多いですけど、多分ボスではないですね。
Exactly.
Their attacks, especially like if you try and actually fight with them, their kicks are just impossibly fast.
Yeah, and they can block just any of your moves, including the tackle. And like Murph said earlier, unlike the bosses, they take no chip damage.
Yeah, so here there's another.
Ah, 今の回復アイテム多分体力マックスまで回復できるので取るのを遅らせていた感じでしょうか。
Yeah.
In this case, again, he's Vulture, I think his name is here.
Wayne, yeah. Vulture's the last iteration.
Ah, all right.
So remember when we said walls are good?
この敵も多分ボスではなさそうな雰囲気ですね。
Yeah, bosses normally have invents on getup, so their second iteration doesn't.
Yeah.
Oh.
Loops.
All right, so this is another
really exciting one. このアダムがさらわれたので取り戻しに行くというストーリーですが、
結構な移動距離ですよね。
発生
した瞬間から持って当たるという。
He's too good for that sword.
Yeah. But that is actually on purpose because he specifically wants to drop the sword himself and not get knocked down. Because if he gets knocked down by a jet, the sword can actually be knocked off screen, which really screws up the later parts of this level.
Yep.
So it's not just to troll us commentators.
失礼剣は別のゲームですね。今作、今回のサマゲスタンペックはあまり RPG がありませんが、ロマンシングサガ3は RPG リミットブレイクありましたっけね。RPG を専門に扱ったような RPG リミットもありますので、もしよければ RPG リミットブレイクの方も調べてみると面白いかもしれません。
The thing is, you have up to 3 pickups with the sword, which is why you didn't pick it up then, because if you got knocked down again, then you would have lost the sword. So,
is it 2 or is it 3? I thought you drop it 3 times.
Yeah, you drop it 3 times.
Okay, so he's got one. Yeah.
So these guys are really annoying, which is kind of why he's zoning them out. He really doesn't want them to get close, because then that gives them a chance to punch him in the face.And that's the last thing you want from those guys.
Yeah, and also approaching some ninjas, yeah. Which really want to do the jump manipulation on these guys, because otherwise they just run wild.
このベアナックル2、結構時間かかっている理由の一つに、まあ難易度は高いからでしょうが、雑魚的な体力が結構あって、簡単には殺せないというのがありそうですね。この右上で永遠に待機してる。あ、これは別に単に待機してるだけの雑魚ですか。
Which does count towards the drop count for the weapon too. So even the weapon he's holding, if he loses it, ninjas pick it up and drop it over again, then it can become a problem. And that becomes a really big issue in stage 7 sometimes.
Yeah. And that's why he specifically knocked the ninja farther back, so he would have no chance of picking.
そうですね、難度最高ですね。
So here he's gonna get rid of some of these Galcias, just clear out the stage before he gets to the boss. Because this boss is pretty notorious for, well, being a problem.
Yeah. There are loops you can do on him, but they're pretty hard to do with all the enemies that are around, and he'd rather keep the sword for the boss.
なんかさっき野球場で見た気がしますけど、このボス。結構体力が不安ですが、おっと。こっちが多分ボスですね。R ベアーさん。ここで一回ダウンして、
So he's gonna be fighting Arbear the very exciting way.
Yeah.
With two bongos here to help out.
So unfortunately, one of Max's weaknesses is that he has really poor Z-axis movement.
Ooh, this
so...
will be a good situation.
おっと
Nice.
Yeah. So he can 怪しいところに敵を追い込んでますが。
Oh, that was close.
おっと
Nice.
All right.
完全にはめてますね、これは。
That's actually one of the fastest ways to beat him,
yeah,
too. So that worked out being faster than what I at least what I assume he was intending to do.
Yeah, which is throwing him out with the sword.
Yeah.
So, yeah, absolutely incredible. So, Beach has a ninja at the start here that's.
And even though that ninja looked like he was doing a jumping punch, ninjas don't actually hit you on the way down.The same is true with Electras. It looks like they're doing a jump kick when they spawn.
They even make a noise.
Yeah, but yeah, they don't actually have a hitbox when they come down like that.
Yep, we'll have the. Here's the orange ninja. He's. This guy is really obnoxious before you make him drop his weapon. Yeah. He. But.
Reverse Agari. まさしく Reverse Agari ですね。
Do that.
This is a problem when you let ninjas out. They're really obnoxious. They can do a lot of damage to that backhand of theirs. So that's
that was a good handling of
him. Yeah, that was a good handling.
But unfortunately, that's going to put him in a little bit of an awkward spot for this next part coming
up.
Yeah, this pack is pretty dangerous.
Yeah, honestly, this beach is a really common spot to die. Because even if you don't die there, well, remember those kickboxers? There's four of them in the next area. And if you're not really careful with how you spawn them, you can end up fighting all four at once.And it's a very specific line that you have to kind of wiggle through. That you have to kind of go back and forth on to spawn them.
Yeah, a lot of times when there's a four spawn, it's like literally a pixel difference between spawn. Okay, he's just going for it.
What the?
Oh man.
This could get out of control real quickly.
Oh. Okay, this is good.
That block.
Yeah, that one.
Yeah.
城東の大軍がコメントで被ってますけど。
Yeah, once Max gets at least one grab in here, he gains a lot better
control. Wow.
Like for as wild as that gets, once you get one grab, you can kind of jump around with grabs between one and then the other, and get a lot of damage in, while being safe due to lingering iframes from certain moves.
And one of the reasons why you didn't want to die there is because there's a health pickup right
yeah,
there.
So here we're going to use the trick with the signals.
これがジャンプ、膝蹴り、崩して後ろ投げ。美しいですね。
We also have $50 from Kermis who says, good luck, Anthopants. Love to see the mania run. Hit the guys.
Hit the guy.
And another $50 from Fochon who says, go, Antho. Get the guys.
Oh, thanks, Fochon.
少し多分画面の方多分画質下がったりしてますかね。テレホタイムみたいな誰にも通じないようなネタが入ってはきてますけど。まあもしよければ本家の方映像で、まあ、それほど聞く価値があるようなことも言ってませんけど、こちらの方音声だけみたいなことを言ってもらってもいいかもしれません。
I don't know what it is about these two bongos, but they seem to desync themselves really easily.
That's unfortunate.
そうですね。あのもし何かあった場合には、あの本家の方を開いてもらって音とコメントだけ見るみたいなちょっと体制を取っていただくのが。
コメント欄左下にある歯車マークを押してあのポップアップというところを押していただければ一応チャット欄だけポップアウトですかポップアウトを押してもらえればチャット欄だけ表示することも可能です
それあれですよあの一回ポップアウトであ
URL 貼るっていうのもありますけど
So this fight's kind of nasty because he's got two of these whip ladies and
they have
tons and tons of bikers spawning with them. They almost have no
health, even on main team. They just got one hit worth of health.
Telephodai, まだ現役みたいな。
いや、その頃はあのファンタシースターがね、ドリキャスで、あの、テレホーダイ使ってやってましたよ、A。
急に何か懐かしい。
Well, it doesn't help that unlike higher health enemies, you can kind of knock them away and put them in a position where you know they're far enough away. But since the bikers are just dying and coming in, and dying and coming, you can't
get control of them.
Anthos can do a very specific thing. Yes, Sega.
Sega のゲーム
ハード
だから、ね、Sega の。
いくらでも語れると。
そうそうそう。
So this boss is intended to have some friends here, but you don't really want to do that.
まあベアナックルはね3作ありますけどどれが一番面白いかなまあ音楽は全部こちらさんなんでねあれですけど
今中2はかなり評価高いという話を聞きますがこれなんか新しい跳ね方をしませんか
ああのジャンプを誘ってるだけですね、これね。で、マックスは投げ技が一番強いんで、まあ、基本、あの相手のジャンプを誘って、それで掴んで、そのまま、どっかの師匠みたいですね。普通に戦うとむちゃ苦労しますけどねまあさすが RT スピードランということでね対策きっちり、はい、してますよね やっぱ2の方が優秀か。
ストーリーご存知だったりしますか？
ね？ストーリー？
はい。
なんだっけ。
前作操作キャラクターの一人がさらわれてしまって、それを助けるみたいな話みたいなんですけど。
そうそう、アダムが拉致されて。で、まあ、アクセルとブレイズが ね、いるんですけど、まあ、そのところに、まあ、またミスター X からそのアダムを救いたきゃ来いとかいう意味のわからんメッセージが届いてきてですね。で、まあ、そこでアダムの弟のサミーっていうのが出てきて、まあ、合計4人で行くっていう。
このマックス君はどこから行きたいですか？
マックスはですね、アクセルの親友です。
あ、アクセルの親友。
はい、それなんで、この作品のよくある話ですけど、あのパワーキャラは必ずいなくなるんで。
ということは、このマックスも次回作には出てこない？
3いないです。適度にメガクラ使ってますよね。He also has a jab infinite, which isn't. 本当ね、マニアって敵硬いんだよね。敵硬いわ、HP だけはもうめんどくせえ。ノーマルだったらね、全然こんな大変な思いしないですよ。本当爽快感あるゲームなんで。
ちなみにマックス君は、マックスはアダムの親友とかではない。
じゃないですよ。マックスの親友です。
あまりにも優しい。I'm gonna do that.
Okay. So he's gonna throw it off the screen there, and that's. な三倍ぐらい硬いんかね。確かね。This ninja is way towards the end of the screen too. This isn't. Yeah. And we hope he does not throw Anthem Bands. まあキャラ固有技が結構あるのが。やっぱりいいとこですよね。あ、やべ、これサブタイつけてねえや俺。
あ、やっぱり人。
人への鎮魂かって入れるの忘れてた。
今はいいですか？
まあ一応入れときましょう。
やってきます、やってきます。
すいませんね。1がね、怒りの鉄拳で、3がなんだっけ、3なんだっけ。
3はないですね。サブタイトルが
差ない、ないっけ？
ないみたいですね。
まあ女性でもお構いなしに殴るっていう、ね、まあ某ゲームではこれは女じゃないよ、男だよって言い放った作品とかもありましたけどね。ええ。言うたらあかんやつか。
まあ、相手はこっちが親友の友達を拉致してますからね。We're coming up on the real chaos of this run. The real last boss of Streets of Rage 2, Stage 7 elevator. Yeah, this is
so all this time we've talked about like playing slow and spawning a few enemies at a time. You can't do that. Yeah, it's not a choice. You're on a single screen. And also those two trash cans. まあ、ボあの裏に奥に今ゴミ箱があるんですけど、まあ。ここが結構敵が湧くんですよね。で、何ウェーブだったかな。4、5。あ、4、さっき4つってた。4ウェーブって言ったんでね。Another interesting trait you saw there, Max's slide has two hits. One hits like immediately. エレベーターが上がっていくんですけど、どっから出てくるんでしょうね、こいつら。
さっきの野球場のスタジックが行くエレベーターもそうでしたけど、こいつら本当にどっから出てくるんですか。
彼らジェットエンジン積んでるからすごいよね。時代を先取ってるよね、こんな一人でホーバーできるジェットパックなんて持ってるとかさ。
しかも量産型という。
like they're super decent. So.
Yeah, やっぱね、小城サウンドいいですね。
You weren't okay.
What?
I'm not sure.
私も小城サウンドやるのだけは知ってますから。
Invince won't work for the froze, so you can still get hit. You can still get crap.
Perfect.
で、まあ。今だったら任天堂 3DS でも売ってんのかな。確かセガの 3D 復興プロジェクトがあったはずだから。
あるみたいですね。
私はあの Xbox 版でベアナックルコレクション買いましたけど。
Xbox にある。
はい、3作揃ってあるので。
ちなみに、3DS 版のベアナックル2は864円。864円でちゃんと協力プレイがローカル通信で対応しているという。
おお、それはいいですね。
This is why he wants the sword.
Yeah, ずっと登っていくんですよね、これね。
The only particularly consistent way to deal with the kickboxers on the elevator.
ここは刀を振ります。
Kickboxers will block the sword.
Yeah, just easy peasy. Just stick your knee up, it'll be fine. That guy. Okay, he's got one more use on the sword. There you can see block thunder tackle, which is a problem.
あとここで残機がもう1減って6まで減りましたね。この辺からやっぱり割と厳しそうですね。敵があまりにも硬い。
硬いのが。
It is kind of not a huge deal, but it is kind of important to make sure that you trigger them to start throwing grenades because if you don't, then
ここは残機溶けやすいと思いますけどね。普通にやってもきついしね。
And wait for them to do it.
今ここのここがフェイバリットソングって言ってましたね。ここが一番好きな BGM って言ってましたけど。難易度マニアなんで体力高い上に。
ダンキもう一回ってどこまで減りました。
If there's six knives on the ground, then the game kind of has to get to the game's object limit.
Yeah, there's only six spaces it can use to knives. Yeah. Beautiful.
これはいいですね。
There's only six
spaces it can use for items. いるところを食べるの。
Taking advantage of the fact that Soya, the knife leap thrower guy, gets up faster than the fat guys and just atomic drops right onto them.
I think this is six, right?
Yeah, that's six. There's four there, one on the left and one on the right.
Oh yeah, there's one.
いやうまい方だと思うけどな。すごいうまい方だと思うけどな、俺は。マニアでこんだけできるのは。
このマニア、ワールドレコード保持者ですか。
で、ここのボスですね。モール来るとパーチ来るだっけ。
これは画面のキャリーですか。
アンチラインですね。ここから多分絶対釣れないですよ。そうです、手前の方がアンソファンっていうアカウントでやってらっしゃる方ですね。あの画面映さないんで、ここ。
何か画面、壁を殴っていると敵が死んでいる。
で、ラス面ですね。はい。
Yeah, those bosses blow up. By the way, here's that boss again. In case you missed
that. ボスがもうあれさっき倒したやつがまた出てくるってもうね、次の名前は違うんですよ。こう、あの量産型なんで。
They also have a rather nasty counterattack if you try and throw them, where they'll you have one frame on me and they'll just electrocute you instead of you getting a throw.
上げて。こんなもん、こんなもん、大丈夫？
私的にはまあさっきでもまあ少し小さいかなぐらいだったんですけど。少しノイズ入ってしまうので、
ああ、そっちか、そういうことね。
SL 側から上げますね。
はい、ちょっと待ってね、ちょっと待ってね、直すね、直すよ、直すよ。こんなもんかな。
そうですね。
後ろでザーザー言ってるのはね、扇風機。
あ、もう今は多分かなり直りましたね。Pipe loop them, except you will get to the end of the screen eventually.
Another thing to mention about Bear is that most bosses behave normally when hit, but Bear is one of the bosses that
suffers from stun. 僕の後ろから長あの回してるから。A lot of times they'll just punch you right back for trying. 私はエアコン使わないので。That was really well
handled. So this elevator,
綺麗に重ねて。
There's a lot of stuff that happens here and a lot of boss refights. He does get health refills. There's no like, drop, but every time the elevator starts moving up, he'll get a pretty good chunk of health back.
Basically the equivalent of an apple. And did you miss the loop?
Nope, I got it.
Because it's back again. Hooray!
うわ、さすがに。
あ、うまいですね。
ボスではないですよね。
これ中ボスがいたはずなんだけど、どこで出ていくんだか分かっちゃったな。これが中ボスだっけ？違うよね。どこだっけ？どこ出てくるかもう忘れちゃったよ。
なんか怪しげな爪の忍者的な。
ここ確かまだザコオンパレードだったはずなんだよ。
結構ボスラッ
シュ。ボスラッシュじみたことを平然と最後やってくるから。
Not that the enemies are clear, he can now just completely light this guy up.
長いで、大きいですね、このつかみは。
あ、入った。パターン入った。
So this is where the ultimate warrior, I mean Zeke Usano appears. And, And while you can throw him on wake up, if you don't do it fast enough, he will break out.
Yeah. あ、そうか。ここ一番上に登ったら芝か。
If you just punch him, then typically he'll end up doing that counterattack and nailing you. But got control of the screen, so now we're gonna suplex him into the wall too.
Yep.Would you say that was more perfect than your stage 4?
That was the most perfect.
I mean, it would have been nice getting a no death 8 elevator, but it was pretty good, yeah.
Ah, perfectly hammered it again. That's good. It's the basic. This is the
background. And behind it
is the crazy man who actually attempted no death attempts of this game. And he's actually gone up to stage 8.
武闘家風の男の方がすごい。
ちなみに芝はね、確かモデルがいるんですよ。
そう、
確かモデルがあって、誰だっけ？
Shiva's okay if you manipulate him, but man, if you try and fight him honestly, you're gonna.
その漫画俺読んだことないから知らないんだよね。
Now he's doing a safer strat.
No, I got it.
Baits him from far away, or just does that.
Okay. Now we've got Mr. X, who, as many people know, decides he wants to use a gun.
Mr. X, 銃を持ってくれ。
ミスター X はサブマシンが持ってますんで、遠いと発砲してきますよ。
ズルですよ。
ほら。
残機なしとラウンですね。
Yes. I mean,
で、彼、まっすぐ横に打つだけじゃなくて、
手前にもちゃんと、
斜めにも手前に打ってくるんですよ。
Super fast. Holy cow.
これってどういうイベントなの？これはチャリティーイベントです。チャリティーイベントで、タイム。
タイムですね。
で、持ってるのはトンプソンっていうね。
That time is really close to world record.
That's like less than 10 seconds. That's a super good time.
That is a super good time.
早いですね。かなり早いですね。
はいはい。
I'm impressed.
Yeah, yeah, I'm very impressed too. So what's really funny is that I was checking in Anthopants to this marathon. He said, I'm going to get world record this marathon. So you were close. You know,
yeah, I was really close.
I'll respect that. So, and, you know, I was like, you know,
I don't have to get world record.
But yeah, I was running at a world record pace. World
record pace is 51.39.
Which is really dangerous.
まあ、約7秒差。
7.5
秒差ぐらいですね。
Yeah, that was really good run.
ちなみに寄付金額については多分最後の土日で急に来るんで急にぶっ込んでくる人がいるんでまあまあまあ分かんないですよ行くまでいつもどのくらいまで行くか
ということで、デアナックル2、死闘へのリクイエムでした。
なんか、急に喋っちゃってすいませんね。
いやいや、全然、聞こえました。この後、
ロックマン
シリーズが続きますね。
ですね、ロックマンが。まあ、3つ続きますね。
ロックマンのコンスタンシー、ロックマン、7、ロックマン、8と続きます。ロックマンシリーズはすべて解説の方いらっしゃいますので、楽しみにしていてください。では一度失礼します。
We have $200 from MVO.Who says thank you to everyone that have made this event possible? GDQs are part of the best weeks of the year for me. Love from France. You are all amazing people. We have $75 from Dark Gizmo, who says love the event. As a game programmer myself, I love seeing games being broken and trying to imagine what is happening in the background for such things to occur. All right, before the Mega Man block starts off, we're going to kick it over to an interview for Mega Man 8 by Darkman, Orsa, and Clear Tonic.
Hello everybody, welcome back to Summer Games Done Quick 2018. My name is Darkman and I'm here to kind of kick off our Rockman block, our Mega Man block. So we're going to be starting with Rockman No Constancy, but a little bit later we're going to be having a Mega Man 8 race and I have the two runners of that race. We have Clear Tonic, Orsa. Fellas, welcome. Happy to have you here.
Thanks, great to be here.
Yeah, absolutely.All right, so let's kind of get into it with this race going on. So Mega Man 8, it's not really a game that we've seen a whole lot of at GDQs before. Last time we've seen it was at SGDQ 2016. So what are we going to expect out of this?
Yeah, I think, you know, Mega Man 8 is definitely its own breed. It has kind of a different engine compared to many other games. Rockman Forte is a similar engine to Mega Man 8, but it's definitely its ownbeast that has kind of like unique weapons that you don't really see compared to some of the other entries, and it's one of the longer titles for sure. There's basically every stage has two parts to it, so yeah, I mean, like, there's a lot of quirky things like using Rush Bike, and we'll see, you know, tech that's interesting like ball jumps, mm-hmm. and interesting use of the weapons, so it's like it's really cool and something that's quite unique compared to the rest of the series.
For sure, yeah.I love Mega Man 8's weapons more than anything. I think they're the best part of the game. Being able to combine them to use platforming and defeating enemies is the coolest part, so I'm really looking forward to that.
Awesome. So, and now specifically, this is a race. I mean, you guys are pretty close friends, I'd say. You know, you guys have kind of gone back a while. How does that kind of affect your mentality going into the race? Obviously, you know, I would imagine both of you want to win, but at the same time, you don't want your, you know, you don't want your friend to stumble. So, like, how does that factor into the race?
Yeah, I think we've been part of the same community for a long time, and we both, like, are clearly capable and respect mm-hmm. each other, but also have, like, a competitive slight to it, and then we want to both just...put on a good show and a good race. So I think we're like here to win, but at the same point, we're just like capable of what each other's, or we understand what each other's capable of. So it's just like guns blazing, hopefully it goes well.
For sure. More than anything, I just hope the race is close, yeah. which knowing Mega Man 8, it probably
yeah.
will be.
Yeah.
That's cool. So yeah, with Mega Man 8, it's definitely one of the longer classic Mega Mans. Of course, when we say classic Mega Man, we're talking about Mega Man 1 through 10. It's probably the longest one. So with it being close to an hour, how does that kind of affect your preparation? How does it affect your mentality going into it? With a game with games like classic Mega Man games being really really tight precision focused tricks.
So I think Mega Man 8 is actually a really, really good marathon game because it sort of warms up really gradually. Mm-hmm. Like the first couple stages, there's some like auto scrollers to sort of ease you in, and then the movement really picks up later on. So I think it's not the worst game for like a marathon. There's nothing crazy in like the first or second stage.
Yeah, absolutely. It's not like 55 minutes of constant, you know, playing the game at like a super high level. It definitely has a nice slope to it. But near the end, you have a lot to worry about in terms of like managing your weapon and your HP and make sure that you're like actually safe and you're not gonna blow things up. So yeah. It feels natural. It's good.
Okay. All right. So we got some hard-hitting social media questions that we got on Twitter. So I hope you guys are ready for this.
Let's do it.
Okay. All right, so first question from one Princess Proto says, what's the most useful special weapon besides the Mega Ball?
My vote's going to go for Ice Wave. It's very, very good about clearing. So Ice Wave is the move that you use, and it basically travels along the bottom and clears out most of what's in front of you. And it's like has a ton of damage potential because it can hit an enemy multiple times that's larger. So. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, Ice Wave is really good. I'll take Flash Bomb. Ooh. I think Flash Bomb is super useful. It's a high damage weapon, and it also leaves a lingering hitbox, so it's really good for clearing enemies with a lot of health, because it'll just keep hitting them over and over and over again.
Oh yeah.
Cool. All right, okay, here we go. From Vegeta Reese, Orsa Cleartonic, what did Bugs Bunny hit Elmer Fudd with for him to be able to invent Mega Man?
Well, this is probably a reference to the voice acting. Mm-hmm. We're playing on the Japanese version today, so the voice acting is just flawless, no problems.
Yep.
Nothing?
I have no idea.
Okay, good answer. All right, so we have from at Blake Rosser, probably my favorite social media question of all time. Orsa Cleartonic, what is Mega Man's favorite condiment to enjoy with chicken tenders?
Ranch dressing.
Ranch dressing with a nice slice of beet meat should be good.
Mm.
The bird?
Yeah.
That's really rude. all right, so that's going to do it for our social media questions. Thank you very much. I have one final question. All right, you guys may be friends, but we're throwing the lines down. Orsa, why are you going to put Mr. Tonic over here in the dumpster?
The dumpster?
I'm not. He's winning.
Oh. All right, Tonic, why are you winning?
He's winning.
All right, well then, I guess there you have it. They each think the other person's winning. There you go. So that's going to do it for our interview. Thank you very much, guys. Cleartonic, Orsa, they are the Mega Man 8 runners. But first, before we go anywhere, we have some lovely prizes. Unfortunately, Sent is being occupied by Chompy. Chompy is feeling sick right now, so he's taking care of him. So I'm going to go ahead and show off some of the cool prizes that we have here. So starting off, we have this lovely statue. Look at this, a wonderful handmade statue you can see right here. It's pretty cool. This is custom made. You can see kind of like the transition from rock to Mega Man. Pretty awesome if I do say so myself. What do you guys think?
Yeah.
Cool.
Awesome.
Cool.
Statue.
So this is awesome. $40 donation gets you a chance to win this. And this is going on until the Taskbot block. So you got a long time to win this. I would definitely get a donation in for that. If that's not your cup of tea, we do got some other stuff. Tonic, what do we got? Yeah, look at this brilliant acrylic paint in the year 20X or 2000X, excuse me. So that's really awesome painting. So that one is open until Goof Troops. That was graciously given to us by Studio Pen Pen. So thank you very much. So yeah, those are some of the prizes you can win during the Mega Man block. But you can, of course, go to gamesdonequick.com to see what else you can win. But yeah, that's going to wrap it up for us. Once again, Tonic, Orsa, thank you very much for taking some time to answer a few questions, and we'll be looking forward to Rockman 8. But before that, we're going to go ahead and throw it over to the host as we get ready for Rockman No Constancy.
Hello, Summer Games Done Quick. My name is not Tokyo Scarab. I'm Proto Magical Girl, and I am going to be your host for this upcoming Classic Mega Man Friday Block.
はい、戻りました。
業務連絡ですが、
本日の、
はい、
ボーダーランズまでは、 アーカイブとして中さんが頑張ってあげてくださったようなので、中さんに感謝しつつ、アーカイブ、気になるゲームがある方は、見逃したゲームがある方は、アーカイブから見てください。そして、この、ロックマンノーコンスタンシーの解説していただきました、初夏さんです。